Assalamu alaikum, grade 4 students. How are you all? I hope you all are fine. This is your English lecture. Open your new Oxford Modern English textbook. Hold your pencils. Today we will start a new unit, a new story. Lesson number 2. Pip meets a convict. Pip meets a convict. Write down date, day and classwork on the top. First of all, we will read the unit or lesson about the story, what the story is about. About the author. Charles Dickens is known as the greatest writer of the Victorian era. He wrote a huge number of novels and stories that were very popular in his lifetime and that remain popular to this day. He was known for creating wonderful characters. Dickens wanted the world he lived in to change for the better. He campaigned for children's rights, education, and the reformation of society to make it more equal. Okay, now we will start a story. Pip meets a convict. My father's family name is Pirip and my first name Philip. But as a child, I could not say either. So I called myself Pip. And then so did everyone else. I say that my name is Pir because that is what is written on my father's tombstone. And it is what my sister told me. My sister is married to the blacksmith. We lived in a marshy area down by the river, a few miles from the sea. One day I stood in the churchyard and looked over my parents' tombstone at the dark, flat wilderness beyond the churchyard. The marshes were crisscrossed with ditches and mounds. In the distance, I could see the gray line of the river and then far away the sea. It was a cold day. The gray land and the gray sky made me feel sad. I suddenly realized that I was an orphan and I began to cry. "Hold your noise," cried a terrible voice. It came from a man who had just stepped out from behind a gravestone. "Keep still or I will cut your throat." This man was frightening. He was dressed in a rough gray clothes and he had a big iron chain on his leg. He was an escaped convict. His shoes were broken and he had an old rag tied round his head. He was dirty from being soaked in the muddy water from the ditches. He was covered in scratches from nettles and stones. He limped and shivered and glared and growled. His teeth chattered in his head and he seized me by the chin. "Oh, don't cut my throat, sir," I pleaded in terror. "Tell me your name," said the man. "Quick." "Pip, sir." "Once more," said the man, staring at me louder. "Pip, Pip, sir." "Show me where you live," said the man. "Point out the place." I pointed to where our village lay, a mile from the church. The man looked at me closely. Then he turned me upside down and emptied my pockets. There was nothing in them but a piece of bread. The upside down view of the church righted itself when he placed me on a high tombstone. I sat trembling when he ate the bread ravenously. "Now look here," said the man. "Where are your parents?" "There, sir," said I. The man jumped and made a short run, but then he stopped and looked over his shoulder. "There, sir," I timidly said, pointing to the tombstone. "Oh," said the man. "So who do you live with? If I let you live, which I have not made up my mind about." "My sister, sir, Mrs. Joe Gargrey, wife of Joe Gargrey, the blacksmith, sir." "Blacksmith? Huh?" said he, and looked down at his leg. After looking at his leg and me several times, he took me by both arms and tilted me back as far as he could hold me. Then he stared me into my eyes. "Now look here," he said. "I need to decide, will you let you live? Do you know what a file is?" Yes, sir. And you know what grub is?
Yes, sir.
After each question, he tilted me over a little more. This made me feel helpless. I was in danger. You got me a file. He tilted me again. And you get me a grub. He tilted me again. You bring them both to me. He tilted me again. Or I will have your heart or liver out. He tilted me again. I was dreadfully frightened and hoped that he would not drop me. I clung to him with both hands. He dipped me backwards and rolled me round so that the church seemed to jump over its own weathercock. Then, still holding me up in the tombstone, on the tombstone he went on. Early tomorrow morning, with that file and the grub, you bring them lot to me and that old battery over there. If you do it, you don't say a word about me. I will let you live. If you fail or say anything at all about me, then your heart and your liver shall be torn out, roasted and eaten. Now I am not alone. There is a young man hiding with me. In comparison with me, I am an angel. That young man can hear us now. That young man has a secret way of getting out a boy and his heart and his liver. A boy cannot hide himself from that young man. A boy may lock his door, may be warm in bed, may tuck himself up, may draw the clothes over his head, may think himself comfortable and safe. But that young man will softly creep and creep his way to him and tear him open. I am keeping that young man from harming you at the present moment with a great difficulty. I find it very hard to hold that young man off of your inside. Now, what do you say? I was so frightened, but I said I would get him the file and I would get him what broken bits of food I could. And I would come to him at the battery early in the morning. Promise on your life, said the man. Promised, and he took me down from the top of the tombstone. Now, he went on, remember that promise and remember that young man and get home. Go, good night, sir, I stammered. It was going to be a long night for me, said he. He looked at the cold, wet, flat marsh. I wish I was a frog or an eel. He hugged his shuddering body in both his arms as if to toll himself together and limped towards the low church wall. He got over it slowly like a man whose legs were numbed and stiff and then turned round to look for me. When I saw him turning, I was threatened again and ran home without stopping. Adapted from A Great Expectation by Charles Dickens. It was a short, story that was taken from Great Expectations by Charles. Now, what you have to do is, students, you have to read the story by yourself. Write these words as dictation: battery, blacksmith, churchyard, course, convict, file, grub, marsh, needles or nettles, orphan, ravenously, tombstone, weathercock, wilderness. Write these words, dictation words, then use these words and write their meanings from there. Also make sentences of these words, okay? Reading, writing of dictation words, words meaning and word sentences. Today is your homework. Okay, students? Complete all these on your notebook. Try to do neat and clean work. Okay. Allah Hafiz.